Range is the simplest form of understanding a measure of dispersion. Now, range, to simply understand, is a difference between the maximum and the minimum value. Now, we have a very simple example here, 10 values to go, and the lowest value here is 40, the highest value here is 100. So, what would be the range? Range, I can simply calculate, is the highest value, which is 100, minus the lowest value, which is 40, and this gives me 100 minus 40, that is 60. So, in this case, my range is 60. Now, what I do is, I remove the biggest value, which is the 100, and I have the values from 40 to 60. So, my range now changes from the maximum value, which is 60, and the minimum value, which is 40, gives me a range of 20. In the prior case, I had a range of 60 because my extreme value was 100, and here, my range changes to 20 because my highest value is now 60. So, range is definitely affected by the extreme values, but range is affected by the extreme value, denoting that it is a measure of dispersion and variability and is very, very important to understand. Also, range is an important measure because it can become highly unstable when there is a sudden change in one of the values or one of the extreme values changes, and therefore range is also considered as highly unstable. So range, a very simple measure of dispersion under statistics. So under statistics, we have measures of central tendency, measures of dispersion, and measures of relation. Under central tendency, as we know, we have mean, mode, and median. Under dispersion, we have range, mean deviation, standard deviation, and range is one of the most fundamental among those.